That competitiveness, that's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there, because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, it looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration, and he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. Khalil Mack in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to fourth down. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. And Boswell's kick is good. And they take the lead here as it's now 9-6. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took them a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. On first and 10, here's Carr. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
On the counter, here's Bell. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And his throw is incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. And the Steelers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 14. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Bruce Irvin able to drop him for a loss of 12, and it'll be fourth down. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They'll try and throw for it with Roethlisberger. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Carl Joseph. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback, a rolling left, and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
And this will be caught at the 30. A big play there just before halftime. 41 yards. The last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Carr to throw after the play fake to Lynch. And this one's incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. throwing his car on third down. Roberts with it over the middle. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
6-18.
Throwing on first down is Carr. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Jared Cook, as the first half is winding down. And the Raiders are able to cash in for six.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Are you looking forward?
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
Now, that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And down he goes, brought down, a Raider sack. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. On second down, Roethlisberger. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the 5. And spins away. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Out comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. On second down, here's Carr. They'll set up the screen to Lynch. Pushing through tacklers at the 30. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
So nursing a slim lead, and that is the opposite of protecting that slim lead.
All I can think here is that head coach, he knows more about what's going on with his team than we do. He must know something's up. Either he has trouble with his punter, right? He's worried about his defense. There's an explanation in there that we're going to ask for after the game, because in this situation, that would be...
And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Steelers are able to strike for 6. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And did he get the feet down? No, they'll say he did not. It's incomplete. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it'll stay at 1.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for 2 too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up 2,
yeah,
right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for 2 here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. Now a play fake here on first down. And complete right side to Cook. Give him a couple on the catch at second and eight.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football. And getting your toes tapped in bounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. Michael Crabtree, the intended receiver, third down here. Working from the gun, it's Carr. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off, it's the Pro Bowl corner, Joe Hayden with it. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Here's Roethlisberger to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Mario Edwards able to run him down for a loss of a yard. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now Bell. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Second down, the ball on the 2 here. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those 3 touchdowns, he's got him in the lead. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Throwing now is Carr. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Roberts. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. Play action. Now it's Carr. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Another big hitter there.